Good morning, students. Children, today we are doing the fourth part of our revision, and this is video one. We'll be taking up 1.6, unit one, the alchemy of nature. Now, we do not have 1.5, okay? So, this is the last chapter that will be taken up in unit 1. So, what is alchemy? Now, if you look into your textbook, you have the meaning there on page number 39. An ancient forerunner of chemistry about attempts to convert base metal into gold. Actually, alchemy comes from, you know, it's in the word in science, in chemistry. But here, when we are talking, in what context are we talking about? We're talking about in context with nature. Okay? We're talking about nature. There is a lot of miracles that take place, a lot of changes that takes place in nature. Okay? So, here the author is talking about the mysterious power or magic that can change things. So, let's see a little about the author. 36-year-old Raksha Bharadia, she is a homemaker turned writer, born in a Marwari family in Kolkata. Raksha studied political science at the Loreto College. A young writer, isn't it? And let's see the summary of the chapter. Raksha Bharadia, the author, tells us that nature is the best teacher for us. Nature whispers and commands. We see the hibiscus flower blooming and wilting on the same day. We see the water turning, taking years to change the shape of the rocks. We see small bits of grass peeping through concrete pavements, trying to tell us that nothing is impossible. We see a bare tree in winter becoming green and colorful in summer. What do you understand by bare tree? A tree which does not have any leaves or fruits on it, okay? It looks empty. But even the bare tree, what happens in summer? It becomes green and it's colorful. We see small ants lunging a big fly. Lunging means trying to carry with great effort, okay? These instances means examples, what we see, show us perseverance, not to give up. Perseverance means where you try hard and don't give up. We see an oyster changing a grain of sand into a pearl and a caterpillar changing into a beautiful butterfly. This is the alchemy of nature. So this is the summary of the chapter. But children, you have to read the lesson. And you have to see the previous video, okay? See the previous video of this chapter to understand better, because explanation is done there line by line. Now, in your text, if you see, you have a grammar question coming up on page number 42, okay? The B part. Page 42, the B part. Please open your textbook and see. You have transitive and intransitive. Now, what is transitive and what is intransitive? Now, transitive verb, remember children, they have an object, direct object. And it will answer the question what and whom. Clear? What and whom, remember this. So, you will ask the question to the verb. Now, look at this. Now, the definition is given. Transitive verbs are not just verbs that can take an object. They demand objects. So, always transitive verb, what it has an object. Without an object to affect, the sentence that a transitive verb inhabits will not seem complete. Meaning, whenever you are talking about transitive verb, there has to be object. Okay? Now, let's see what the object, what do we mean by that. Action that have a direct object to receive that action. Example, the doctor cured him. Now, if I have to ask you the question, doctor cured whom? Him. So, it is answering the question whom, and it has an object. So, what is the object here? Him. So, him is direct object. So when you have a direct object, which verb is it? Transitive. Now, she crossed the street. Does she answer? It answers the question what? She crossed what? No? So when it answers what and whom, it is transitive. So here it is answering it. She crossed what? She crossed the street. So the street is the direct object. Then, Joanne threw the ball. If I have to ask you, what did Joanne throw? What? He threw the ball. So the ball is the direct object. She loves rainbows. What does she love? Rainbows. So when it answers the question whom and what, it is transitive verb. Now very easy, coming to next, that is the intransitive verb. Is the opposite of transitive. It does not require an object. So intransitive mein object nahi hai. Okay, there's no object. Like take for example, snow fell yesterday. Now which is the action you fell? Your snow is subject, right? And fell yesterday. Fell will be action. But we cannot say snow fell on whom. Does it say snow fell on Tina? No. If it asked, if it was that way, then it would have been transitive, no? On whom? But here it is just said fell yesterday. It's not answering whom or what. So in other words, is there any object there? No. So when there is no direct object, what is it known as? Intransitive verb. We failed. Failed is intransitive because it is having no object there. See, we failed and it's over there only. So, failed is the verb, but failed is an intransitive verb as there is no object, direct object linked with it. They jump, which is the verb jump. Now, jump, is it transitive or intransitive? It is intransitive, right? Because there is no object. Come on, let's do the next. The dog ran. The dog ran. Ran, is there an object after ran? If I say the dog ran after the ball. Okay? After whom? The ball. So here there is an object, no? The ball. But here, is there it in this sentence? No. So it will be intransitive. She sang. No. This is also intransitive. The light was shining. This too is intransitive. Why? Because there is no object. Now you have some new words, children. I'm just reading it out for you. Instinctively, by your natural instinct. Instinct means when you say from inner, no, from inside, there is, you know, you have this instinct. Then enhancing, enriching, soothes, makes someone feel calm or less worried. Awe, great wonder and amazement, wilting, drying and dropping. Withers, withers, no? Withers. When we say the leaf withers, the flower withers, it dries and dries. Splendor, brilliant or gorgeous appearance. That is magnificent. That is called splendor. We say, no, when we talk about God and we talk about king, that is splendor, okay? Colossal, huge, massive. Infinity, time or space that has no end. Eternity, time which has no ends or no limits, okay? Then persist to continue doing something in a determined way. When you're persisting, no? Then next you have chapter was over, that means it is dead. It's a phrase, okay? Chapter was over when we say means the person is dead. This, you know, you say this person's chapter is over. That means you mean to say what? He is dead or he or she is dead. Conviction, strong, firm belief. Lugging is pulling with great difficulty. Frail feelers, weak legs. Perseverance, constant efforts in spite of obstacles. Consistent, steady. Unhindered, without disturbance. Ego, here it means pride. And alchemy, mysterious power or magic that can change things, okay? So we're talking about alchemy of nature. There are many mysterious things that are happening, okay, in nature that can change things. Children, I hope you've understood this video. Please watch the previous video of this chapter. Do all the textual exercises. Learn all the meanings. I hope you have already started watching all both the videos because I'm getting some response from the students, some students, not all of them. And of course, your homework. I hope you're doing it in your book, in your notebook. Please do it, because that's going to clear up the concept to you and you're going to understand it better. Thank you so much, and God bless you.